I said there was a sort of a final section about motivating the guru, the thinking part of the brain. And that comes down to something called buyer's remorse. And if you've done anything on sales, you'll have heard of it. Buyer's remorse is the connection between the logical thinking of the guru and the fear and anguish of the gorilla, the more ancient parts of the brain. And to put it into simple terms, it's all about the commitment that you make. So the greater commitment you make in trying to make something happen or take an action, the more likely there's going to be an element of buyer's remorse. And what the commitment turns into is different elements. So it's not just a cash commitment. It can be time and effort, responsibility. So if things go wrong, it landing on your lap. So when you think about buyer's remorse, it's the level of personal involvement in making the decision that strengthens the potential buyer's remorse in the person. And what makes that even worse is we've got something like, they call it the paradox of choice. So the more choices you give someone, it's almost like the less likely they are to make a choice. So when you're dealing with people generally, the magic sort of number, there's about 600% increase in action if you give people only three choices. I'd go a little bit further in some of the care home settings and I'd limit it down to a couple of choices. You tend to get people to act more readily if they don't have to think so hard about a buffet of choices. And when you're looking at the buffet, there's a load of regret about that, what you could have had or what you should have had or what you might have had instead. And that creates anxiety in the person. So what I'd say to you is, if you want to know what the choices are that you want to offer someone, it comes down to the same chestnut. You've got to get to know them. And if you know them as a person and spend some time with them, you get a good idea about the types of things they're interested in, so you can narrow down the choices to two or three items, almost an either or. The positive thing about choice is that once someone makes it, there's a bias to support the choice, an intellectual bias, and they will find reasons to support the quality of the choice that they've made. So if you can supply even vague reasons, they'll magnify that up. So when you're trying to create an element of a good vibe, good words around a group of people about what you're doing, you get a few people into a situation, make sure that it goes fairly well. And it's not rocket science to see that they will talk positively about that to other people. But what I'm saying, I suppose, is say if you were going on a scale of 1 to 10, it went fairly well to a level 6, they'll tell everyone it went fairly well to a level 7. They'll magnify that for you because they made the choice to be there and they support their own choice subconsciously. So, I hope that's sort of helpful, and that sort of shuts us off on that section, and we'll move on into a little bit about emotions and motivating the gorilla more solidly. Bye bye.